Oh, hey there. Welcome to a new video. Today's a big one, you guys. It is the big day. We are going to be renovating the biggest apartment in The Sims 4. Before we get into it, let's thank today's video sponsor. Thank you to CurseForge for sponsoring today's video. CurseForge is the official modding hub for The Sims 4. You can download amazing custom content and mods safely through the CurseForge website and app. So right now I am downloading the basic CC pack. This is by House of Harlicks, and I searched for this and found it on the CurseForge app. It's really great using the app because you do not have any paywalls in the way. You also know that the content you're downloading is safe for your computer, and I absolutely love this pack. Right now, CurseForge is hosting The Sims 4 CC Festival, where every week, three simmers are picked to win $1,000. If you want to win up to $6,000, upload your most creative builds to CurseForge. Check out my link below to learn more about how to enter the competition. I'll put it in the description down below as well. And good luck! Thank you to CurseForge for sponsoring today's video. In San Myshino, which is the world that came with The Sims 4 City Living, the biggest apartment is over here and it's called Spire Apartments. This is three stories high. It has a pool in the basement. I'm tempted to make it a little bit smaller and then maybe put a gym down here as well. And then there's like a living area space. And then upstairs, there are two bedrooms. And there's also a balcony space over the other side. Now, there are a couple of other really big apartments called the Alto Apartments, which are pretty sizable, although they're only one story high. And then the other apartments that are quite big are actually like penthouse building lots, which aren't really apartments. They're more just like a lot on top of the building. So I would say this is probably the biggest official apartment in The Sims 4. I always like to look at the exterior of the building first because it wouldn't make much sense to like do a fully like old warehouse industrial apartment when the building's clearly new. So I think it should be something that's kind of sleek, a bit modern. I definitely think we can utilize this area in a more efficient way. We can fit more in. I feel like I just want to gut the whole place and start fresh. So when you gut the whole place, this is what it looks like. I actually thought I could edit these blocks, but I can't do that. We also have this fence here, which I was convinced we could change, but we actually can't. So we have to have that balcony there. And we also can't be adding any other windows. Well, I guess what I usually like to do is just turn it into a blank canvas. So let's do that. Let's make it all white. I don't know, I just like to have it all white like a canvas. It helps me think more clearly. Definitely makes sense to have the main living area where you enter the building. Or we could have a staircase that you immediately walk up, but that's kind of annoying. I think on the top level, we should have the main bedroom. Oh, wow, did I just paint the walls out here? Oh, that's kind of random. I didn't even mean to do that. We'll fix that later. And I think we should have a bathroom here that's just like a massive ensuite that's super luxurious. Even have the toilet tucked away in there. Maybe a beautiful walk-in robe over on this side. I'm really not sure where to put these stairs. The wall height is the maximum wall height, which means these stairs are so tall. Okay, I think this is the best we can do with the staircase because I want to have... actually, that's not a lot of walkway, is it? Maybe if we move these across one more tile to here, we can have like a staircase area that kind of stacks on top of itself. And I was actually thinking we could use some battens here. I'll show you what I mean. Okay, and this looks so good. Oh, but of course there's still the middle section here that technically probably would need a railing. Or because it's Sims, we could just leave it as it is. Just because it looks cool. So just to give you guys some context, this has already taken me an hour and 15 minutes just to really gut it and do a bit of this master bedroom. It takes so long to do these builds. I think over this side, we could do another bedroom, second bedroom over here. We could have another door here. So it will end up being a three bedroom house, which I think's probably more useful for the size and cost of it. This is quite an awkward floor plan to work with because of these sticky outy bits and where we've put the staircase. So maybe we could do like a wardrobe and desk maybe behind the bed, something like, I wish we could just put the wardrobe in here, but you can't do that. Ideally, I'd really love to have a bathroom in between both of these bedrooms, but I just don't know if that's gonna happen. Okay, I think this is actually working. So you've got the master bedroom over here, their bathroom, toilet is separate. They also have a beautiful walk-in wardrobe here. And then the other side is the other two bedrooms. So one is here and it shares a bathroom with this bedroom. Ah, that was actually a lot harder to figure out than I thought it would be. I think this room's particularly nice right here. And I so badly wish we could move these, but oh well. So this room's kind of better. I reckon, you know, you could like have kids living in the house, or you could actually have staff living here, like a butler in this room. That butler would have such a good, such a good room. For the entry level, I think we should have kitchen, dining, and living here. So maybe if we turn this into a corridor area, so it's a little less open to elements, we could have a nice kitchen in here, like a big galley kitchen. I mean, that would still be pretty amazing because you'd just have that insane view. And then there could be a very spacious dining area here. And then we could have a full-blown lounge room over here. And then maybe an office in this area. Because this also goes out to the balcony. Oh, we should definitely use the... Was this Desert Luxe? The Desert Luxe sofas. Yeah. Oh, we are a little tight on space though. Maybe we have like a sitting room down here, and then on the lower level we do a theater room with a TV, because we still have so much space down here. So maybe you just walk into like the seating area, and then there's a dining area, and then there's this kind of tucked away kitchen. I love this hallway. I quite like the flow of this. There could be a bar over here, or we will need at least a powder room downstairs. So we could just tuck a powder room right into this corner. And then this looks like it just wants to have a bar here. And a lot of you guys say I don't use bars often enough. I don't really like the ones with the lights on them. Ooh, I do like the desert bar. This one just looks really classy, whereas this one looks more plasticky. I suppose we could move it out and then move this down so it functions well within the game. It's probably the best thing to do. And because we do seem to have a bit more of extra room here, we could probably add another two chairs to this as well. Now, this is not the final furnishing necessarily, just trying to get an idea of what will go where. Downstairs, this lounge room fits in quite nicely if we put the TV back on this wall. The problem is because there's windows like on every single wall, it's actually kind of hard to find a spot to put the TV. So they can maybe walk through the lounge room. This could have another lounge area down here, so it's quite generous. And then over here could be a lap pool. So you still have the lap pool in this build. It's just maybe a little bit, oh no, we can't do it right to the corners. Bummer, that would have looked so cool with the windows. All right, let me figure out a different way of doing this. Well, maybe it should just be like one really slim pool. I mean, I think that looks really classy. And then you can see out all of the windows. I would pull it to the edge if I could. So I guess we'd have that room through here and maybe have a few base game glass doors. We do need some kind of bathroom down here. I mean, we could put one in the corner here. Or I'm actually thinking we have a bathroom, shower room down here, and then a gymnasium in this area. So in here would be the gym, and then you go into the pool area. Okay, for this build, I was thinking we go with a lot of neutral colors, golds paired with blacks and grays. I kind of like these being put together like that for a change. Although it's using some warm colors, I personally wouldn't describe this as like a warm home because it kind of is gonna look too perfect. Like I feel like the Sim who lives here, they just wanna kind of flex that they have a lot of money. And they're not really concerned with making a family home. Maybe they just want a family home that above all else shows their wealth. So that's kind of what I'm envisioning here. Or this is an apartment that's like going to be sold furnished. So it doesn't have like a lot of personality, but it does look pretty glam and pretty lovely. Pretty lovely, lovely. I wonder if that light, what was it? From the Maximalist pack could work here, because this has a great like gold classic look to it. It could have some more old school elements too. And I guess with these chandeliers, it does have that old school fancy pants vibe, like a little bit old Hollywood glam. But I also want to bring in some contemporary feels with some plants. Oh, whoa, look at that gold swatch. Holy dooly. Maybe it's that, I feel like that's maybe a bit too much gold. We'll do a little bit of white here. And then I feel like they would want to flex something pretty big right here. A high school football trophy, a sales award. Let's just put some gold bars right out there. You know, if it's not already obvious that we're rich, there you go. I was actually thinking the classic Princess Cordelia sculpture. I was going to go like the full gold, but I'm actually thinking, you know what? Let's tame it back a bit. We could have a music award up there as well. And an MVP trophy. No, that's too much. I can't. It's too overwhelming. Maybe a Sulani vase size down. No, it still doesn't look right. Is this the best rug we can do here? Maybe we could try something like this. Honestly, I love the brown or the black. Maybe the black to tie in with the fireplace. These are really cool, but the thing that I don't like so much about them is because they're just 2D and flat. They just kind of look like posters. I guess there are $475 posters around, but it just cheapens the look of it a lot. I wish it was in a frame, and I would probably use it a lot more. These Sims seem like the Sims who'd have a wine glass on their wall. I absolutely love these chairs from high school years. They seem like fancy chairs. Like, I just imagine them in really high-end places. And again, I feel like we could maybe do better with the rug situation. Even just a cream one is pretty nice. Oh my gosh, imagine cleaning a cream rug under a dining table. Is a zebra rug too cringe in this house? Or is it kind of a vibe? Oh my gosh, imagine having like a view like that from your office. That would be crazy. It is the next day, you guys. This is taking a very long time, this renovation. I think I'm PMSing because I'm absolutely exhausted. Nothing coffee can't fix. So I decided zebra actually was going to work in here. I just needed a more like organic looking rug, and the colors work really, really beautifully. So this is looking both classy, interesting, and like a wealthy flex, which was the vibe we were going for. Maybe a little bit more lived in than I had anticipated. So yeah, we've got that. Maybe let's work on the kitchen next. I'm never really a huge fan of any of the kitchen cupboards. This is kind of the point where I always want to use custom content, because the custom content kitchens are just so, they just look so fancy. But you know, this looks pretty good too. If we get an end piece, we might, we might be able to put a bin in there, but actually I think it's better just for the purpose of gameplay simplicity to just place the bin like this. That way your Sims will be able to definitely use it. I still can't get over that view from the kitchen. I still remember a video I watched. I think it was by, was it Ingrid Nilsson, the YouTuber? She had an apartment in Dumbo, New York City, and had like a view out the window of the Dumbo Bridge. And I was like, oh my gosh, it was the first time it really registered in my mind that some people live like that. I don't know if she would still live there, but that was pretty cool. What do you guys think about Sims appliances? I typically don't use too many of them. Like, I usually put in a coffee machine of some kind or a tea maker, and that's kind of it. I'm gonna let you guys place in anything more you may like to use. Actually, you know what? Let's get rid of the second sink and just put the coffee machine over here. That's where you can add in whatever you like on the benches. And then I feel like we need some fancy pantsy plant over here. What looks fancy? This is kind of fancy. Yeah, that's fancy. Cute Iggy Azalea music right now. Ooh, fancy cake. Yes. Honestly, I think that's a good simple kitchen. This room is just, this is cool. I like it. I like it a lot. Then the office is looking like this. Love it. And then I did do this outdoor area. It's a shame there's not much room out here, but we've done what we could. I like the hot tub. I'm gonna put some of this like gym clutter around here to make the gym look, whoops. Wait, I just want a single drink bottle to make the gym look a little bit more convincing and lived in. Maybe we'll put a drink bottle in this little bathroom area too. And then this room over here. So this is like a downstairs TV room, because really upstairs would be the formal lounge room. So I've just grabbed a few pieces. I'm not really sure what I want to use yet, but I guess we'll go with a similar theme to upstairs. I mean, these are really cool, but I do feel like they're a little bit tall for the couches. Like, oh, we could just size them down. Now, we can either center to this wall or center to the windows. It probably would work better centering to the windows. And we can give the illusion of symmetry with this wall by, like, putting a painting or some kind of wall art there. Or even we could just place that there. Part of me is tempted to turn this into, like, a dark wood wall, but then... because I love the contrast of this against the cream walls we've picked. Let's do that. Wonder if we could make it look like these bookshelves are built into this. Oh, I don't think it's gonna work because the books are being cut off. What about this shelf? Yeah, that looks good. And I also really like these base game rugs in different colorways. Like, they're kind of a very classic, you know what I mean? I thought if I size this down, we could have another seating area over here with just armchairs. You could put like table tennis table over here as well, skill building items. You could probably even fit in another bedroom if you wanted to. Let's get some classy wine colored chairs over here. Actually, if we want to do like a back-to-back situation, we could place one of these. I mean, two of these. Actually, maybe just that with a couple of lamps on it. I don't know why in like wealthy mansions, they always have this thing behind the couch and then they have two lamps on it. And I just don't understand how the lamps are powered. Like, is there an electrical socket underneath this couch that these like run through the console table to below? Like, how does it work? Is this an American thing? I don't understand. It's literally something I think about all the time. This is looking really fancy. Fancy, fancy. And I think actually these green chairs work better than the plum ones. I just think they look nicer, but that's a fancy, pardon me, living room. Just wondering if we should change the curtains to maybe a warmer color, maybe like a sand. What do you guys think? I think this looks better. Like, it just looks like it goes with the rest of the apartment. How good are these curtains though? Like, desert luxe. Oh, so good. Oh, what's happening here? Excuse me. Thank you. Excuse me. Just want to show a little bit more of that color over here. Nice. Yeah, that turned out really good. Well done, you guys. And should we put another sconce light over here? Oh, I might even like that more than the upstairs one. Oh no, the upstairs one looks pretty refined as well. Okay, so that's pretty much lap pool done. Downstairs, bathroom. That looks great. So now we move on to the top level. So for the main bedroom, we had worked a little bit on the layout initially, but it's really just the bare bones. It doesn't look very nice yet. I think this room should be quite monochromatic. Like, I feel like it should reflect the rest of the house. So maybe we keep this one pretty like cream and plain. And then the other rooms we can have maybe a bit more fun with color. Although we could put these paintings in. I love these base game paintings. I have very fond memories of The Sims 4 when it first came out and discovering the use of these. Not a huge fan of this desk. Maybe go with this one in a cream and gold. We could size this down, maybe do a mini one. Oh yeah, that's cute. Yeah, I think this looks good. Ooh, maybe we should do this. So that's size down. Yeah, it kind of looks like a hotel room. Oh, you know what we should put on here? We should put the watch. Yeah, fancy. And maybe some nice trainers as well. This room could be like a really nice sage colored room. We could go with nice color coordination for these beds. Let's pop a plant here and a chair on the other side. Or maybe just like a poof sitch. Hashtag poof sitch. And this really gives off an earthy vibe, an earth aesthetic. You know what I think would look really good here? Eco lifestyle, green wall, baby. Oh, it's actually, okay, maybe we went a little far with the green. The gray is nice. What about this like off brown color, like a camel brown? Okay, so that room's nice. Let's move on to this third bedroom, which I think will make like a blue room. This bedroom's actually a bit of an awkward one to furnish. It's kind of a weird shape. And I typically would never put a bed in front of a window, but I'm gonna make an exception here. We could actually do like a TV on the wall. I forget that a lot of you guys too have TVs in your rooms just because I can't have TVs in rooms. Oh my gosh, that's such a lie because we have one in Sydney in the bedroom, so we do. But I never use it. unless I'm like sick. Or if I go and stay at a hotel, I like a TV in the room, like a treat. Yeah, so because I don't really use them in the bedroom, I always forget them to put in bedrooms in The Sims. I know this might be a little bit strange because usually I just put a desk in the corner over here, but I was kind of thinking maybe it would be an interesting use of the space to have it against this wall and then have a sitting area here. Actually, what happens if we use like the YouTube booth or Sims Tube booth? All the electronica, like this maybe, so if they had friends around, or they could play to like an audience of friends or family in the lounge. That's actually quite a cool idea. And then we should get some neon lights on the wall. And then I think this really starts to feel like more of a teen bedroom. Do you remember in The Sims 3, there were these like glass circular tables and I would always intersect them? Well, these look quite nice when they're nested. Yay. Then I think we just need a rug in this corner. Cool. All right, well, I think that is all done. Let's do a tour of the whole place. All right, everyone, welcome to our affluent three-story penthouse. Yeah, it's a penthouse because it's on the top three levels. Very cool. I've moved in the Feng family. And let's take a look at this place. Oh, I love it. He's ready to walk in. They're like, let's walk into our new home. Okay, so once we walk in, I really wish we could have changed that front door. This is what it looks like. It looks so good. I feel like this is so convincing of what a penthouse looks like. It's a little bit vanilla, like a lot of earthy cream and black tones, a little bit monochrome, but I think it also has an earthy vibe. So it's quite tasteful, if I don't mind saying myself. So right through here, we have the amazing office. Wow, look at that sunset. So that's pretty cool. You can turn this into whatever you want. And then just to the side of this is their incredible balcony. Whoa. So I wish we could have done more with this, but you know, with the space that we had, we've made it look okay. So this is our formal living area. The floor plan turned out fairly good considering that it's not the easiest shape to work with. We've also got a gorgeous dining area. Where's my chandeliers at? Oh, there we go. We really need those chandeliers to really, you know, show it off fully. Ah, now it feels complete. Nice outfit. Someone's been hanging out at the trendy store, it seems. So if we turn around the corner, we have a very simple kitchen. Couldn't really do all that much in the kitchen area. I feel like if we had custom content counters, it could be made to look a little bit more fancy. I love this stairwell. I think the stairwell turned out really good. And like this long table here. It looks like they like the stairwell as well. And look, you could definitely put in some railing, but just to keep the aesthetic of like simple designer staircase, I didn't put that in. We've also got a very small powder room in here. Should we go up or down? Let's go downstairs. All right, so downstairs, you have this gorgeous window and you turn the corner and then this is our rumpus living area. Very nice. Simple yet generous. Lots of living areas to hang out in. You could do a lot with this space. Do you guys like it? I think so. Then just through here is the gymnasium. Of course, if you had a big family, you could convert this into more bedrooms, a butler quarter area. But this is our gym. I also am so excited to finally use these tile side tables. I didn't really have a use for them yet. And then we have our lap pool. Pretty classy. And then through here, you can also access this from the gym, but this is a bathroom and shower area and locker room. Going up a floor, you come upstairs to this crazy landing. I used some fancy wallpaper up here. And let's go to the master bed. Very nice. I do quite like this little sitting area and the desk. Just to the side is a gorgeous walk-in robe. And then through these doors is the ensuite. There's like a nice big spa bath, double showers. It's actually easier to show you guys from above the floor plan because it's a bit tight in there, but you've got these behind the wall and a separate toilet over here. So it's private in a way, except for the fact there's these massive windows. In here is the green bedroom, which has more of an earthy vibe. And then we have the blue bedroom. I think this is my favorite just because it's a more creative use of the floor plan. I really like how this plays to an audience in the corner. And I guess this room feels like it has the most personality. And I totally forgot to furnish the shared bathroom between both of these rooms. Whoops. Oh, I was gonna say, where am I gonna put the toilet? But the toilet's in here. It's missing a little toilet roll. We really need a more modern toilet roll. So just so you guys can see the floor plan, I know a few of you guys like to copy what I've done and do it yourselves. So this is the top floor. Take a screenshot if you like. This is the middle floor. And then this is the downstairs with the lap pool. And I'll also put this on the gallery for you guys to download, although I'm going to have to put it as three separate rooms. So I'll label them like top story, middle story, bottom story. So you guys can place that. Unfortunately, The Sims doesn't make it very easy to put apartments in your game. So you'll just have to download it as rooms and kind of compile them together, sorry, and fill in the walls. But thanks again to our sponsor today, CurseForge, and make sure to check it out if you're interested and enter the competition. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Thank you also to my members who are helping out a lot with this channel. If you want to join, just click join down below or click the link in the description. I hope you guys are having a lovely morning, afternoon, or evening wherever you are in the world, and I can't wait to speak to y'all soon. Dag dag!